After a 30% tumble over the holiday weekend, digital currency Bitcoin bounced back a little bit today, the digital currency briefly climbing more than 12.5% above $16,100 late Tuesday morning. But Bitcoin has recovered more than 50% from its low of $10,400. They hit that Friday in an extremely volatile day of trading. Money managers Michael Lee and Melissa Armo join me now to discuss this. And over the holiday, did any family members come up to you, either of you, with questions about Bitcoin? What did you tell them? Melissa, you first.
Hi, well, thanks for having me. Happy New Year.
Thank you very much. You too.
Well, you know what? It's funny when you talk to people about Bitcoin. They either absolutely love it and they think it's going to like 100,000, or they don't understand it at all. So yes, I did talk to people about Bitcoin. I think Bitcoin is anything that you can trade. It's something to trade. It's speculation, but it is very volatile, as you said. And, you know, I don't know whether or not people have the stomach for it. So I would say be wary unless you really like risk if you want to trade Bitcoin.
Michael, I'm curious what you told your, you know, your guests or your friends about this, because I think that Bitcoin, and I get all kinds of things wrong, but I think it's about as valuable as that box of you-know-what that was sent to Secretary Mnuchin that we talked about earlier in the show.
Well, you know, most of my Christmas conversation revolved around Barbie, Moana, and My Little Pony. So not a lot of Bitcoin talk, even though my youngest daughter, who's three, thinks it's going to the moon.
Okay.
Look, I got to agree with Melissa here that Bitcoin is pure speculation. Hey, there is really interesting concepts behind it, that a digital currency that are there only so many can be created, that can be transferred anonymously via some of the latest breaking technology that's out there. However, there's no case to be made whether it's worth a lot more or worth a lot less.
No.
The governments could come in and shut this down at any point in time.
Look,
so it is pure speculation.
And if you're laundering money because you're selling drugs illegally, this is a godsend because it's blockchain. It's blocks of data, and they have a very hard time tracing it. So I would imagine lots of people breaking the law love this. But we have to move on to the next topic. U.S. economic cheer rewarding retailers this holiday season. High consumer confidence and a robust job market lifting U.S. retail sales to their best pace since 2011. That's according to MasterCard, by the way, which tracks both online and in-store spending. Michael, we're going to go through some of the numbers as we're talking here. When you exclude automobiles, sales were up 5% this year compared to 3.7% last year. And is this going to be seen as a win for President Trump? And then, Melissa, I got a follow-up to Michael's response for you.
So I'd say the only surprise here is that people are surprised. Consumer confidence in the U.S. consumer has been doing really well since 2013-14, all the way into Trump's election. And the difference in Trump's election is things just took off. And what the real difference we've seen is over the last few months is the consumer savings rates, which had been double the pre-crisis levels up until about 6 months ago, has fallen off a cliff. Some would say that might be leading us down the route to ruin, but I disagree. I think the savings rate has been so high, it's fallen off a cliff, and that's why you're seeing this extra spending,
Melissa,
right now. I don't see it stopping anytime soon.
Melissa, I'm curious what you think about this, because a lot of this was credit card spending, and I always get worried because we're at pre-recession levels and people are defaulting again at levels we haven't seen in a while, and people could be using their credit cards for the essentials, not for gifts. What do you say?
Well, don't lose any sleep, Adam.
Okay.
Don't worry, because the tax breaks that are coming, people are going to see more money in their paychecks, so I believe that probably that's one of the reasons that people are spending more, or just kind of spending ahead. And there have been a lot of big sales. I think look for a strong close in the last quarter of this year with 70% off, even after Christmas sales. A lot of these companies are getting a lift, and people are charging them. That's true. But,
gotcha.
I mean, they're expecting tax breaks.
Melissa and Mike, I got to let you go, but thank you. And you bring up a good point about having that extra money, because I know at Comcast, they're getting a $1,000 bonus, and they'll be able to spend that money. So both of you, thank you very much for joining us here at Fox. President Trump just tweeting about American jobs and businesses. We'll tell you what he said after this.